probably come to church. Amen? Next week we'll celebrate his birth. Now we all know he wasn't born on December 25th, but that's when we celebrate. Amen? We all know that it was in a manger where he was born. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords was born in a manger. He came to us in a humble way because that's who he is. Amen?
Closed in an echo chamber. The word of God reverberates and spreads out. So if you are just happy to be found in the house of the Lord, whether it was because grandma said so, or whether it was because you just something tugged on you and said, Facebook wasn't good enough for today, whatever it is, I just want you to stand on your feet and just bless the Lord. Bless the Lord for just being in the house. Bless the Lord for just knowing that He is so good and He has not loved us so. We can be celebrating this season. We, you know, Christmas is not a day, it's a season of remembrance. The remembrance of how much God loved us. And so we're just thankful to just be found in the house of the God of God, to know that God loved me so that He took the time to come off of a holy throne and said, I'm going to just put on clothes of humankind so that they know that there is a way back to me, that they know that this life you can get through because I went through it, so I can tell you, you can do it too. Today is the day that God has said, rejoice and be glad in it. So just go ahead and rejoice and be glad with it. Now this is the day that the Lord has made. Yes. Go ahead.
You know, we had a Bible lesson this morning, and it was fabulous, I want to say. It was about the telling of Mary that she's going to have a son that's going to be the son, the leader of the world, leader of everything. And that lesson, we all know, we've all heard about Mary going to the manger and having the baby and Joseph and all those good things. But to learn the inner workings of what really happened that day, do you know he picked a 14, maybe 16-year-old girl to do this? 14 to 16 years old. And that right there tells me that she was heavily favored. And not only that, she's turned and said, she was a little puzzled. I mean, anybody would be here. The angel come to you and say, you're going to have a baby and you haven't been with a man. But at the same time, she believed. She believed that this is where it came from. And that, to me, reading that lesson was so powerful, I had to come back up here and say something about it. And I think we all got a good understanding of what was going on during that time. Am I right, Miss Bobby?
That's right. You're right.
Am I right, Bill?
Yes.
Am I right, Cole? We were there, and everybody had their own opinion, and everybody had something to say. And you know, that adds to the lesson, when everybody has something to say. So I just want to say, it fired me up to read that lesson throughout the week. And I was ready to teach that lesson. I was only 10-14, actually. But I want y'all to come on. If you haven't come on with us to Sunday school, come on with us to Sunday school. We start at 10:15. Come on in. We're informal, but we do study the lesson, and we want you to learn the goodness of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
That's all I got to say. I'm going to move out of the way and let Pastor take over. Amen?
Amen.
All right. So it's about being a witness. It's about being a witness of what we would say, a manifold witness. That's what nature, heaven, nature, and humans come in. I'll come get it. But this morning, I want to welcome those who are worshiping with us on Facebook. And I want you to stand looking at the time. We're going to go right to our doxology. We're going to begin our worship and witness to God this morning with praise God as we stand.
Praise God.
the Lord our God. I will seek thy good.
Those that remain in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God.
Blessed are they that dwell in thy house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth.
For the Lord is in his holy temple, let all the earth keep silence before him.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer.
Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all the earth sing his praise.
This morning you stand is found on page 100.
Thank you. in reverence of what this means right now. There is something that is very special. Every parent knows it at the birth of a child. Let us pray together. Eternal God, our Creator, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, we come this morning saying thank you, God.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you when you saw our wretched condition. You sent a Savior. He put on human flesh and became like us. But yet, with the spirit of holiness that you have and all power, oh, we say thank you, God. We thank you for this day and this time. Oh God, there's so much going on, and when we look at those who are without a home or a place that they can find shelter, our hearts ache for them. And we ask, oh God, that you move by your mighty power like only you can do, and heal our land and prepare for those who need you so much. Oh God, we thank you for this time of worship, that we can come into the house and bow down and say, singing and blessing and praises be to your name without restrictions. Thank you, God. Thank you that you are still healing our bodies. We are in process. Thank you for every family that is represented here. And for those who are on Facebook or other mediums, we say thank you, God. We think about all of those who have come before us, our parents who taught us the way, those who have gone from this side to the other side, and yet we feel the nearness of their spirit even right now. Thank you, God. And we ask, oh God, your blessings upon this church, this pastor, this congregation, and for all those whose hearts are touched by this ministry. We pray, amen.
That's the gospel according to Matthew, chapter 1, verses 18 through 25. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man, and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what has been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son and named him Jesus. From all that dwells below the skies.
Responses in the
shepherd who leads us like a flock. You who are enthroned upon the cherubim, shine forth.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Let the great day shine, that we may stay safe.
How long must we pray? How long must we fast? We need your love. We need your love. We need your love.
Restore us, O God of hosts. Let your face shine, that we may be saved.
Restore us, O God, through the power of your love. In a time when even love is in need of love, we turn to you through your love. Show yourself mighty and strong.
Start with the bottom. Start with the bottom.
Light the candle of love.
Can't miss joy. We thank the Coggins family this morning for doing our fourth candle of Advent.
Thank you.
for your faithfulness. Thank you for your commitment. And thank you for your willingness to serve. So we had Friday night, we had our quarterly conference where we reported all of the good things that we've been doing. And we've been doing a lot of good things this quarter, so that was good, good announcement. The, also, on yesterday, we had our monthly food pantry, and I thank you for showing your love in action, and it was a great success. So all that hard work that went into that, thank you, thank you, thank you. You won't care. You know, you got a number today. All right, let's, as we tell the kids, let's put our listening ears on. Okay. Tell me what you learned today downstairs. One person, tell me one thing they learned downstairs. You learned about Jesus. Good, thank you. You remember last week, we were talking about a young lady named Mary. Do y'all remember that? Okay. And we were talking about how she was in a difficult situation, but she still, during this difficulty, she still had what was called joy. That she, even though she was going through a rough time, she was singing praises to God. Right? You remember that? When we talked about that? Well, on the other side of that, there was a young man named Joseph, who was engaged to Mary. And when she, he found out that she was carrying this child, he was going to no longer be married to her. Because it wasn't his child. That's a really hard thing to fathom as a young person, that someone tells you that I'm a child and it's from the Holy Spirit. That's very hard. But he loved her enough that he was going to do it nice and gently away so she wouldn't be disgraced. Because in those times, if a young woman was not married and had children, they would stone them to death. So he cared for her. So Joseph was looking at the situation and what other people thought about him. What were the other people going to say? So I have to do something because other people are going to say this is wrong, even though he believed what Mary told him. So an angel named Gabriel came to him in a dream. And he talked to him, and he explained to him, this really is what God wants, and you should go ahead and do it. And so he said, okay, what it is that I want you to know, when God is asking you to do something, it may not agree with everybody else has. Mm-hmm. It may not be popular. It may go against what the world says. One thing, I'm going to ask you, what is one thing God tells us to do? Yes, but something even more important than that. You ever heard of love, thy honor, thy mother, and thy father, so your days will be long? That's something God tells us to do. It's not always easy because we see our friends talking back to our parents, right?
You don't see your friends don't do that. You don't do that, right?
We see that we don't mind, and we don't. If your parent, your mom, dad, your grandfather, grandmother tells you to do something, and if you don't do it, is that honoring your mother and your father? No. But what we want you to know that when God asks you to do something, you can have the courage to do it. You can honor your mother that your days be long because you have the courage. God is going to stand with you in the tough times. So just like Mary was very, could still be thankful and rejoice to God because she had joy that went deeper than the outside situation. Joseph, who was so worried about what everybody else was thinking, was given the courage by just talking to the angel. Sometimes we need to just go and talk to God in prayer. And the angel showed him that you can have the courage and do this. No, you're not like other people because you're special. And what I want you to know today, you're not like other people. You're special. So following God's word can be tough, but you have to do it. It's not going to be what society, what people on the outside, what the community always says, but you can do it. Okay? All right. Thank you.
Just remember, if God has told you to do it, you can have confidence to do it and not worry, because God has your back. Next Sunday is Christmas. We will be having worship service live. If, by some reason, the weather is not cooperative, we will still have worship via Zoom at the same time. We're at 11:30, either in person and Facebook, or we will be in our Zoom room, and we will try to get that to connect to Facebook, but we cannot guarantee that. We've had some technical difficulties, but we will be worshiping the birth of our Lord and Savior live on next Sunday. The preacher today is the Reverend Sondra Hunt. She is a good friend, and she knows the Lord. She knows the Lord. Now, I can stop right there, because there's a, she was a biology teacher at Shaw High School for 30 years. She was the pastor in the Senior Church in Cambridge, Ohio. She was a pastor of Unity Tabernacle Church of God. And God puts people in your life that you don't even know how connected and how close they are. We were worshiping at Christ Our Redeemer in the early 2000s. And Sister Martin was a musician there. And we had come to love and adore Sister Martin, who is with us today. So glad to see you. And we went over to Unity Tabernacle because that's where my great-grandfather founded that church. So that was home base for us. And so we went over there to worship with them one Sunday after Christ Our Redeemer. And on the piano was Reverend Sondra Hunter. We did not know that Reverend Sondra Hunter and Sister Martin were best friends. But that's how God works together and knits us in to be woven into a family. And that's where we are almost 20 years later, still together. So I just want to say that it has been a great relationship when we find people in the Lord. So after this song, the next voice that you will hear will be that of Reverend Sondra Hunt.
Thank you. of the one who died and went to heaven.
Yes.
His name is Jesus, and we come today, Lord, expecting the Godhead to show up. I yield Sandra to you, Lord. I yield my lips, my tongue, my throat, my everything to you. Use me like you want to. I plead the blood of Jesus over this congregation, over every child, every boy, every girl, every man and every woman, every clergy, every lay person. In the name of Jesus, let the sheep of your pasture be fed with manna from on high. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We call your attention to the book of Isaiah. And we shall be looking at the 9th chapter. And we shall be looking at the 6th verse for an Old Testament scripture. For to us a child is born. To us a son is given. And the government will be on his shoulder. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. We also invite your attention to the gospel according to Luke, the 2nd chapter, beginning with the 8th verse. The gospel according to Luke, the 2nd chapter, and the 8th through the 14th verse. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. Yeah. Yeah. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. Uh-huh. I bring you good news of great joy. There will be for all the people today in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men, on whom his favor rests." If you need a title for the message this morning, it is in the form of question. Do you want to have peace? The word peace in Hebrew means shalom. There are several words in the Bible that have to do with peace, like Salem. Melchizedek, the king of Salem. Solomon, king of Israel, meant peace. But this particular peace I'm talking about is not the absence of conflict, but it is wholeness. Do you want to be whole?
Oh, yes.
I took an orange and logic lesson. The children can have this when it's over. I cut it up in pieces. And it's not whole. It's just a piece.
Okay.
You know, at Christmas time, the Reverend Dawson, we say we want a piece of cake.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. I mean, we want, Dr. Reeves, we want a piece of money.
Okay.
We want a piece of something, but God wants you to be whole.
All right.
He wants you to have the whole thing. He wants you to have shalom.
Uh-huh.
And so, when you meet up with one of your friends who are members of the Nation of Islam, we call them Black Muslims, and they seem to be very proud to say, Assalamu alaikum, which in Arabic means peace. You say back to them, shalom. You're scaring the day. Because they don't think Christians know anything. This gives you an opportunity to introduce them to the one who can give true peace.
All right.
Muhammad can't give you peace. Buddha can't give you peace. Only the peace man, the one who served in the office of peace, to give you wholeness. When I thought about what is whole, and I decided I would confer with Mr. Webster in his dictionary. And it says whole means to make sound.
Yes.
Whole means in a healthy state. It means restored, and it means healed. And my mind started to work, and I said it means not broken. It's perfect, and it's complete. It's an entire thing. It's having it all together, and it's not divided, and nothing is missing. It does not mean that it's just the absence of conflict. This peace that I'm talking about, that Jesus is going to give to you. This peace, it's like a homonym. It's two words that sound alike. It sounds alike, but they mean something different. In fact, they mean just the opposite of each other. They're actually antonyms, though they sound alike. Because this means peace, and this means he says. How did mankind get in pieces? It all started in the Garden of Eden, where everything was at peace. There was no hurricanes, and there was no tornadoes. There were no bug bites, and there was no ant bites. There was nothing to cause you pain or sorrow. And I believe old Satan, whose job, Jesus said, was to steal, kill, and destroy, got jealous of that. He saw the special relationship that man, Adam and Eve, had with God. And he decided to interfere, and he went to Eve and said, didn't he tell you to not eat of the tree of good and evil? And she believed him, and she ate some, and she enticed her husband to eat some. And that came about. They had it whole.
Yeah.
After that, they got in pieces. You know why?
Jesus.
They got banished from the Garden of Eden.
Right.
And then the man had to work by the sweat of his brow before his work was like play. Right. And the woman didn't suffer pain, but the Lord placed a curse on both of them. One would have to work by the sweat of his brow, and the other one had suffered pain in childbirth. They would no longer have peace, they no longer would be whole. But he also cursed Satan, the serpent. He said to them, you're going to not stand on two feet anymore, you're going to crawl on your belly. But he gave us a promise of the peace man. This is one of the first promises in the Bible. Over in the book of said he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by stripes we were healed. But this is something you don't hear too much about, I think. If you go over into the 65th to the 66th chapter, you'll find, beginning with the 17th verse, that there's going to be the establishment of a new heaven and a new earth. And that is going to be peace. That means no more tornadoes, no more hurricanes, no more sickness, no more sorrow. All will be joy. There was a man named Tommy Dorsey wrote a song, "There Will Be Peace in the Valley." And he spoke of this peace in the valley. And he said, "There will be no sorrow." Our man Isaiah said, "The lamb and the lion will lie down together." And that peace, there be no prey-predator relationship. And so this Jesus is coming back. This peace officer, to give us peace, he'll come one day. He's already come as a babe to die for our sins, but he's coming back and establishing a reign of peace. God bless you.
Amen.
And now I belong.
here in the sanctuary, the altar is open. So, on Facebook, we thank you for joining us today. We will be live next Sunday. We invite you in the sanctuary or to join us online. Thank you.